What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to Michael Knapp Fishing. Welcome to part two of the treble hook modification series in our modification tips and tricks playlist that we've put together. If you are new to the channel, welcome. I greatly appreciate you tuning in. Go down there, hit the subscribe button, or actually you can go right over here and hit the subscribe button, or over here. One of the two places, I can't remember where I put it. Turn on your notifications and you're actually going to be able to compete to try and win a Tackle Warehouse gift card that we do post from time to time. We put the code in there and the password, and you just type those in to Tackle Warehouse. First person to find it and use it, you're the winner. I don't care what y'all do with it. So today's video, we are going over treble hooks again. I'm actually not even going to show it to you yet. We're going to roll that juicy intro and then we'll dive into it. All right, guys, so when we talk about treble hooks, I talk about treble hooks a lot with my crankbaits and my jerk baits and my topwaters. Like that really narrows it down to all treble hooks, I guess. But I really love treble hooks on my topwater baits because sometimes those fish, they don't always commit fully, but when you have treble hooks on there, you have a greater chance of getting them to connect. You have a greater chance of them accidentally hooking themselves and being able to bring them into the boat. So in today's video, we're going to talk about feathers. Pretty much to feather or not to feather. What is the advantage of a feather? What is the disadvantage of a feather? Why do we run a feather? So that's what we're going to kind of get into. So some of your baits like this one, let me grab it out of here. Right off the bat, it's a Rapala Skitter. Pop. Oh, I can't remember what it's called. Either way, it's a popping bait, a little popping bait. Comes factory with a feather on there. A lot of baits come factory with a feather, but a lot of them don't. Same style baits. Some do, some don't. So what is the purpose of a feather, and is it worth it or not? So the purpose of the feather, if you remember last Tuesday's video, it was the VMC bladed treble. It was a treble hook with a willow blade on. Actually, I have it out here. The VMC bladed treble. It does the same thing as a feather. Two different styles of back treble hook. If you want it, you run it. I run it on the back. Two different styles of it. One has the natural shine and a twisting motion in the VMC blade. And then the feather is going to have a very unique puffing motion. And it's one of those deals that I can't replicate it outside of the water. It's something that you have to see for yourself. So the easiest way that I recommend you seeing this, take one of these little pop. I mean, everybody's thrown these. I mean, I remember being a child throwing these. Take this, put it in the water, and just pop it a few times, and you'll actually see the feather pulsating. Kind of like how our jigs do. You know, when you throw that jig down there and you let it hit the water, that jig puffs out real nicely and just kind of sits there. And then when you jump it, it pulsates in and out. And it just gives nice motion to it. And the treble, the feathered treble, does the exact same thing. It actually gives those fish something to hone in on and something to see and be like, hey, that's something different. I want that. So, where does this shine? What can you put it on? Why do we put it on there? Well, for example, the poppers, the little skitter pops, whatever you call them. Great little bait to be able to draw in those fish. And all this is going to do is add something for them to see and hone in on. That's got red in it. They're going to be able to catch that with their eye and be like, hey, I want that. 9 times out of 10, if they don't engulf the entire bait, I guarantee you they've got the feathered treble. So there's one bait that you can add a feathered treble hook on. Another bait that I really enjoy adding a feathered treble on are walking style baits. These are phenomenal baits to add this feather to on the back. As you walk it through the water, you know, it does its little jaywalk thing. That was a terrible impersonation of it. But as you have it back here with this, I put a hook on my finger that time. as you have that feather back here on, and it's walking back and forth, that wet, that feather is swaying back and forth with it. As you stop it and kill it, it puffs. The feather is doing just as much work as your bait is. And that is the beauty of the feathered treble hooks. I don't know when the feathered treble hooks came out and like when they started using them and everything, but it's really a phenomenal bait to be able to add on there for a little something extra to your bigger walking baits. You know, the pencil poppers come with it, and the pencil poppers do, you know, like on lakes like Lake Hartwell and Lake Murray and stuff, anywhere that they're chasing those bluebacks, they do absolutely phenomenal with the feathered treble. Guys, real short video. I didn't want to get too in-depth and get real long with it, but go down there in the comment section below. Let me know what you all think of the feathered treble hook. Do you use it? Do you run it? Do you like it? Do you notice a difference if it has a feather on it or not? I notice a very, very big difference. When I don't have a feathered treble hook on there versus when I do, big difference, especially when that bite gets real finicky. This is kind of just a little something extra that kind of makes the bait a little more finessey, that is going to allow them to be able to hone in on something and actually be able to bite this and find it a lot easier. I think it makes a big difference. I think you'll find that it does too. Guys, if you like this video, do me a huge favor. Hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, leave me a comment down in the comment section below. Let me know if y'all do fish a feather, no feather. What color feathers do you like? What like feather material do you like? Lit Creek Custom Lures make some phenomenal feathers for me out of all kinds of different feathers. I absolutely love them. But anyway, go down there, tell me what y'all like, hit that subscribe button, share the video everywhere y'all want. The bigger we get, the more giveaways we can do, the more times I can give away these Tackle Warehouse gift cards. Be sure to go over to Instagram, check out my Instagram at Michael Knapp Fishing. We do giveaways over there as well. Take care, guys, and I'll see y'all soon.